Welcome back, Kids Gang. It's exciting to be with you guys once again. We have an awesome lineup just for you. Lyle, would you like to open us in a word of prayer?
Yes, I would like to pray. May everybody bow their heads and close their eyes. Lord Jesus, thank you for guiding us all safe through this unknown day. Thank you for waking us up. I pray as you go through Kids Gang service, I pray for all the teachers and all the Kids Gang learners. I pray you will bless us all through this COVID-19. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. This is coming up right now. Well, Kids Gang, as you know, we're busy with Run for Hope. We're done with our first challenge, and this week we have a very exciting challenge once again, and it is called Paint for Hope. So you can ask your mom and dad to help you create something creative, send out a positive message, send out a prayer, or anything that you can do with your crafts. Here we have Lyle, who has done his already. Lyle, would you like to explain a little bit?
Yes, this is three different pictures, but
It's two that looks the same and then there's a difference. That is, my help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. That's Psalms 121 verse 2. And then I have the ship and the water, and it says, when you go through deep waters, I will be with you. Isaiah 4 verse 2. But I make two of Isaiah 43 verse 2. I made two of them, and they all three come together. And I know all of you are wondering why this is a black and blue tree. Because I was trying to get a summer night tree and a winter night tree. Winter is always much darker in the night than summer. And then there's the flowers at the bottom with the rainbows. It's for the summer also. And then there's the scripture in the middle. And you can call my mommy or daddy to get one of these. And they are 20 rand for one picture. But if you want all of them, it's only 50 rand.
Well, Lyle is ready, creative, and doing his Paint for Hope. Kids Gang, are you ready? I see Lyle is going to level up to the next level. Are you ready to join in? Get your parents and let them help you to level up for Run for Hope. Amen.
Come on,
move
and freeze. 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 Put your right hand on your left knee, your left hand on your right. Your knees move in and out, your hands stay tight. Now keep on with your moving, but switch hands on your knees. Keep on moving in and out till we say freeze. Come on,
move
and 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 freeze. Put one hand across your shoulder, one hand across your back. Now jump in place. Do you like it like that?
Yeah!
Now switch hands across your shoulders and switch hands across your back. Now just be nimble, just be quick, just like Jack. Come on,
jump
and freeze. 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 Everybody shake your body from your head down to your feet. And don't stop shaking until we stop the beat. Shake it to the east and shake it to the west.
Shake it, shake it, shake it.
With my friends who are the best. Come on,
shake
and freeze. 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 Put your right hand on your head, your left on someone's knee. Now turn once in a circle and buzz like a bee. Now turn the other way, don't let go or lose your spot. Keep turning left, keep turning right, until the music stops. Come on,
turn
and freeze. Come on,
turn
and freeze. Come on,
turn
and freeze. Come on,
turn
and freeze.
Hello, boys. Hello, girls. This morning I want to tell you a small, short story. And the story starts right at the beginning of time, when God created the heaven and the world, and the earth and the world. And he wanted the world to be a perfect place for man. But man wanted to do his own thing. And then that is how sin came into the world. They disobeyed God and they wanted to do their own thing. And that went on for a long, long time when man was always just being disobedient to God. Then one day God had a conversation with his son, Jesus. And he said, Jesus, the people are sinning and sinning, and I want to destroy this world. And Jesus said, I'm going to go. I'm going to pay the price for them. Send me, Dad, so that I can re-establish the position with God, with man and God. And Jesus went. And Jesus prayed to the people, and he preached to the people about eternal life and heaven. And he said the only way we can get into heaven is if we are going to accept him as a personal savior. That's the only price that we can pay for our sin. There was a man that was so rich, and he said, God, Jesus, what can I do to get this eternal life? And Jesus said, are you following the commandments? And the man said, yes, of course I am. But something is still wrong. Something is missing. And Jesus said, you know what you have to do? You have to just give up all your riches and come and follow me. And that was too hard, because the man expected Jesus to say, oh, come on, you can come with your money and all. But Jesus said, in order to follow me, I'm giving you the free gift of salvation. And the man had to leave very sad, and Jesus was very sad too. He said, I'm coming to die for you on the cross so that I can give you salvation and I can set you free from your sin. This is a free gift. You cannot pay it with money. The only way that you're going to pay it is with your heart to give to the Lord. This is the only way for salvation. So Jesus had to die for our sins. This is our key verse. I mean that you have been saved by grace, and that is the grace of God, because you believe. You did not save yourselves. We can't save ourselves. It is a gift from God. You cannot brag that you have been saved by the work that you have done. So can we just say a short prayer? Father God, just put your hands up or touch your heart. Jesus, we thank you for dying on the cross, and we thank you for the gift of salvation. We thank you that you have saved us, and we know that if we're going to be warriors for you to say no to sin, we are going to meet you in heaven one day. Bye-bye, girls. Bye-bye, boys. See you soon. We love you. We miss you. Bye.
Amen, Kids Gang. Wasn't that just a powerful lesson that we've learned now? Being saved, that's like the best thing that you could ever do. Like right now, I want you guys to be challenged. For this week, take time out and memorize the verse that we've learned in this service. Memorize Ephesians 2 verse 8 and 9. And remember, you have been saved by grace. Right there where you're at, I want you to stand up. Grab a hold of your mom, your dad, your brother and your sister. Even some of you might have your granny with you. Let's all stand together and close in a word of prayer. Father, we thank you, Lord. We bless your name. Thank you for waking us up this morning, Lord God. And as we go into this unknown week, I pray that you go before us. We love you. We thank you for who you are. We pray that you be with each and every child that could tune in this morning. We pray that, Lord, that you go before us and level all mountains in Jesus' name. Now, Kids Gang, we still have some exciting news for you. As we're going into the Run for Hope season, we have boys and girls challenging one another to raise more funds for the honor and glory of God. If you know of anyone that's still out there lost and still needs to hear about Jesus, this is your time. Yes, I said this is your time where you can get your mom and dad to get yourselves registered, raise some money, and then we can all run this race together to save more people. And don't forget, tune in again next week, same time. Speak to your mom and dad to get more data and make sure that you are tuned in. Amen.